Snowden of Great Britain in fourth place, and Tan in China. But let's show you Ron Marriott's dive earlier in this eighth round. He was third after seven dives. Here was the dive he chose for his eighth run, a forward 3.5 somersault with a twist, 2.8 degree of difficulty.
Oh, that was a beautiful dive. Ron has been diving so well in this contest, and I really like his style on this. He makes the dive look very easy, and he's able to go in the water without making too big a splash, which is really what they want to see.
And for that, he got 63 points. He's been improving steadily and very, very consistent. On a beautiful summer afternoon here in Los Angeles at the diving pool on the campus of the University of Southern California. And here he is, Greg Louganis. This one, he's leading now by 52.47 points. But he's not about to let up. This will be a back 2.5 somersaults, pike position, 3.0 degree of difficulty. His degree of difficulty is far higher than anyone else in his competition. He's a full point more difficult than Li Haping of China. All right, let's just watch perfection. Cynthia?
Jack, I'm speechless. Every time I watch Greg do something like that, it's very hard to criticize because his distance from the board was perfect. Let's watch this takeoff. Gets his arms through early enough to get in the dive on the way up, which is very important. The distance from the board is perfect, and it gives him the ability to go in the water straight.
Here's Ron O'Brien, the American coach, and they're discussing things. He got eights there.
I know he's happy with that one because he has had trouble with that dive in the past, but he makes it look so easy.
This is Christopher Snow to Great Britain. He's on the third board over in the shadow of the platform tower.
Yes, this is a forward 3.5 somersaults tuck. Chris doesn't spin very fast, so this is not an easy dive for him. Yes, he did go over. That's unusual for him. I saw him bend his arms as he took off, and that's really not too smart. Note the takeoff here. You see, he comes through with his arms, and he's bending at the elbows there. He shouldn't do that. He should keep his arms straight. And he goes past vertical on the end of that dive.
55-44 for Christopher Snow to Great Britain. Now we come to Li Haping of China. Li Haping in second place, but 52 points more and more than that from Greg Louganis.
Triple twisting 1.5.
Well, they're good, aren't they?
Yes, they are good. I would like to see him go in the water a little more vertically. I think he has trouble lining that dive up. You see, his takeoff is really very strong. That's a nice twisting position. Now he tries to line this dive up, but he doesn't quite reach all the way over his head in line with his ears on the entry.
There it is, 65-25. That should keep him comfortably in second place as we come now to Piero Italiano of Italy. His coach, incidentally, is the Olympic gold medalist Klaus De Biasi.
Because he can't hear his feet contacting the board, he has to feel the vibrations, and the timing and rhythm is so important. He does a very good job with that. I think his sense of feel and his visual references are really important, and it heightens his ability to go in the water straight, and he uses those two senses very well. Let's see what he does with his hands when he hits the water. Yes, he flattened his palms. That's how diving has changed in the last 10 years. The diver flattens his palms in order to make a hole to go through, and it allows the water to be taken down, sucked down with him, and there's no splash as a result.
And there's his score, 63.51, and that should drop him to fifth place. We'll be back with more Olympics in just a moment.
Welcome to the Open Home Collection.
The warmth of